Okay, welcome back to another episode of Cooking with Mr. Dan. Today we're going to make us a nice little dish. I always say that. That's what my daughter says anyway. We're going to be making us some carnivore-style shrimp cakes. These things are really good, easy to make, very tasty. So without further ado, let's get to it. I got my two daughters coming today. They're probably going to eat all these up. Okay, so star of the show is some shrimp. I sauteed these in butter. As you can see, I saved all the butter juice there. I've got some here. I'll show you what I did with my knife. Here I've got my ground up pork rinds. This is about a little over 5 ounces. I got some Old Bay seasoning I'm going to toss in there just a little bit. And here I have some freshly grated Parmesan cheese. And I got a couple of eggs over there. So without further ado, we're just going to get into this. Okay, so like I told you, this was raw shrimp that we got here. And I sauteed it in butter. If you want, you can add garlic, you can add salt, pepper, whatever. I'm just trying to keep this as carnivore friendly as I can. But I got to use the... I say it's Old Bay seasoning, which it is, but not really their recipe. It's mine. I made that a couple days ago, maybe. Ran out of it, so because I put it on a lot of stuff. But anyhow, we're not going to put that much in there. You know, you're not supposed to eat any plant-based stuff on carnivore, but so I guess we can call it ketovore. All right, so just rough chop. Don't go crazy down. You don't want it to... all mushy little pieces. That's what you're going to do. Just take that and put it in the bowl. Then, what we're going to do now, move this out of the way because it's all buttered up. We're going to take our panko crumbs. And I always go through these really... because I grind them up myself, and every so often you'll get a nice chunk. I've already done most of it already. There's one. A little pieces that, you know, you don't want nobody to break a tooth. Okay, so now what we're going to do is add our shrimp. I just took what the rest of the shrimp that was in this bag. I had in the freezer for a few months. Okay, and we're just going to mix that in with our panko crumb here. Might have too much shrimp, I don't know. I think I didn't measure it, so. As long as you can form it at the end of the day, it's all good. If I need to, I can always add a little more panko to it. I mean, there we go with that again. I can add a little bit more pork rinds, which I might do. I'll have to wait and see. Okay, so next step up is... I'm going to take my two eggs. And we're going to beat these up. I always do it in a separate container because if you get shells in there, at least you can see them. You don't want to mix no shells in with the final product, you know what I mean? Listen to me, a final product like I'm mass producing this, right? Get that out of the sea. Okay. This looks so good. I'm going to add a little bit more pork rinds to this just to get a little more kind of a breading feeling. Okay, so I got my scale. I just weighed out. It's almost an ounce more of the panko crumb. So, and you want to let this sit for a couple minutes after you mix it. So, anyway, we're going to sprinkle some of our Old Bay in here. I know you can't see it really, but I don't want to go too crazy with it. And then I'm just going to sprinkle a little bit of this cheese in there, very little, because I'm going to put some on top. But this will help keep it together. All right. Now you can add anything else you want. If you wanted to put some dip sauce in here, or whatever you call it, cocktail sauce, horseradish sauce would probably be good. What I want to do right quick here is get me a little feel. Let's see what we got here when we try to mash this up. Well, that might work. Yep. Okay, I'm going to let this sit for a minute, and then we will be right back. Okay, so you can see the stuff's been sitting a bit now. Get a portion scoop. That's a little big, but it's all right. We'll take that and dip your fingers in some water. I got a bowl of water there. And this helps to shape these a little better. And you put it down. And you just mash them up. These are going to be, they're just little treats. They're not something, you know, you're not going to make for dinner. I mean, you can, but you probably eat the whole tray. Well, you might anyway, I don't know. Okay. I'm trying to make them a little thick, but these are going to be mini. You see, you just take them, like I said, and just mix up a little. Now, if you don't care for the consistency of these, meaning that if you think it could be a little wetter, whatever, you add, throw another egg in there. You can mix more liquid in there, you know, more butter. Really, I don't put too much butter in here because these pork rinds have enough. They come with their own grease built in. So you don't want to go crazy. It's supposed to be an enjoyable treat. Okay, what I'm going to do here, I'll finish up this one here for you guys, and then I'm going to step back for a minute, and I'll finish making them, and then we'll be back. We're going to put these in the oven. I'm going to use my mini oven, and we're going to do about 375 for about 15 or 20 minutes, give or take. We're going to see how this looks, huh? Okay, so again, And I'll tell you, the pork rinds, I'll tell you, grinding them up and making like little things like this, they taste really good. They add a nicer flavor to certain things, I think. Better than flour. Anyway, let me step off here and finish this tray, and I'll be right back. Okay, guys, I'm done with the tray here. I'm going to hit it with just a touch. Touch the old bay right on top, very little. And we're going to take our cheese. Let me turn the oven on. Get that preheated. Okay, I've got about 19 minutes on the clock. Put it at 375. We're going to let this stuff just cook away. Hopefully it'll look nice. You can do it at 350. You probably just have to cook it a little longer. Like I said, these are just like a little snack. There's nothing that's gonna, you know, fill you up or nothing, but be good for the Super Bowl, huh? They're easy to make. Just like those roast beef roll-ups I made with the butter. They're so easy. Okay. I'll set this off to the side and wait for the oven. And while the oven's going, instead of having two pans, I'm just going to stack these on the my Silpat, and we'll swap them out when they come out. Okay, I got three more, so I got a total of 15. You notice these are all different sizes because I said, oh, that's not going to be enough for one. And since I am the chef, this last one over here, a monster, will be for me. My daughter's here from wherever she came from, probably her house. She just showed up, my oldest one, Stefaru. She's working from here today. She wants to spend some time with Mama. I don't know if you can hear him talking in the background out there, but anyway, it's really great having my two daughters work, being able to work from home. My wife still works from home. She loves it. Anyhow, so these are done, ready to go in the oven. Once those ones come out, I'll show you what we got. Okay, guys, you can see it just fresh out of the oven. Let me let this sit so some of that juice gets drawn back up into the little cakes, and put it on a cooling rack, which is over here, and we'll be back momentarily. Okay, guys, all 15 are baked up. A little hit of salt on there, and we'll meet you at the taste test table. Okay, hope everybody's enjoying the day. It's kind of chilly here in Florida. However, that's not stopping my daughter, Steph. She's out on the patio working. Camera girl went for a walk, and she came back. Just waiting on my other daughter, Emma. Okay, so let's take a little, put the hole together really nice. It was delicious, but anyway, you get all the shrimp in there, you got the hint of the cheese. So, my friends, if you like the video, give us a thumbs up, share with your friends, subscribe if you haven't yet. And when you do, you can hit the little notification bell, because I'll let you know each and every time I put up another video. So, this is Mr. Dan saying stay hungry, and when you are, come back, we'll give you another delicious dish just like this. Thanks for stopping by. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy it. And we'll see you on the next video. This is Mr. Dan saying, we're out.